Hi friends, here is Aisha from Aisha App Account in Bangalore. Now we are continuing the exception handling, that is advanced. So in this video, we are going to see the relation between exceptions and workflows. If you really like this video, you please subscribe it and you please refer to our friends. Thank you. So in the foundation level, we have already seen the workflows. Workflows is used to manage its workload. So workflow is a list of cases to be worked by a process. And your process will iterate through the queue working cases in sequence. After working a case, process will update the queue with a result. And queue data is used to measure a process performance and for generating management information. So the process is unlikely to be able to complete every single case, and some will be identified as an exceptional cases. If you remember in queues management, and the status of queues are one is lock queue, completed, exceptions, and pending. And now we are going to say what are those exception cases, how can we visualize those exception cases, and how can we fix those those issues. And we'll help you to visualize exception cases by thinking of a Blue Prism process simply as a machine. So you know that as a for loop, so machine is used to do specific job over and over again, and without considering ourselves how the machine works. And we can see that cases are fed into cases in means data or records, whatever, and one end of the machine, and results will come out of another end. And in ideal world, the machine would be able to do all its without encountering any difficulties, means in ideal scenario. But every case fed into the machine would be completed, but whereas in real time it's not possible usually. But unfortunately, the reality is that the machine will occasionally encounter problems in some cases and will not make it all the way through completion. These unfinished cases will require the attention of a human being, and we will say what are those issues, application problems. And if you recall, if you go to a foundational level, and so rather than failing in the event of exception, so Blue Prism can be configured to cope with or handle the exception and try to keep going. And by using various stages resume, recover, exception, and block stages. And here, exception handling is a critical part of any Blue Prism solution and should be designed with the same level of care afforded to other parts of a solution. And if you remember, so happy path is not at all sufficient in any application development or in a process development. Obviously, we have to measure, we have to check about an unhappy path, and we need to consider that an unhappy path called exceptions are nothing but errors. Means we don't want that one, but usually we'll get such kind of errors called errors or exceptions. So here, every type of exception is not possible to recover, and sometimes it makes no sense to attempt a recovery. And the ability to handle exceptions at least will provide us with an opportunity to decide what to do when processing does not perform as expected and the logical flow has strayed from an ideal path. And in most, exception handling should be done in a process or a component level. Business objects can contain exception handling, but in general, they should kept as a simple and reusable pieces of logic. And if you remember in the first video in exception handling advanced, we have already seen that the business object contains an exception very less, almost like a zero. Okay, and please stay with us for more videos on exception advanced.